Here's the proof that the convergence of absolute values implies convergence. So the idea is, if your series with absolute values on all the terms, if that converges, then so does your original series without the absolute values. So in other words, the absolute values are at least as big as all your an values. So if that converges, then so is your an. So here's the proof that you should know for a test. An is trapped between the negative absolute value and the positive, because maybe the an terms are negative. You know, we don't know. Some of them could be negative, some could be positive. But it's definitely trapped in between these two values. So then we add absolute value of an all throughout the inequality statement on all three parts. So this gives you 0. It adds in here in the middle, and it adds on the right, and you get 2 of them. So we have our given part of our statement. If this absolute value an converges, then certainly so does 2 times it, because, you know, if the series of absolute values converges to some number, then 2 times it converges to 2 times that number, so it converges. No problem there. So we have that, and that is equal to, of course, 2 multiplied in, because you could take the 2 and factor it back in. All right, so we have that this series of an plus absolute value of n converges, since we know this one does, due to our given statement. That converges, and the terms of our series here are less than or equal to those terms, 2 times absolute value of an. So by the comparison of series, since we have that this series converges because each of its terms are less than or equal to something that converges. Now, step 5. Since an is less than or equal to an plus absolute value n, let's talk about that for a second. If you add on an absolute value, that's a positive number that you're, or 0, that you're adding on to an. So of course an's are less than or equal to that. So that means that this series is less than or equal to this series by a term by term comparison. But we already said in step 4 that this series converges. So by comparison, that means the sum of an converges. So that proves a theorem, because back up here in the statement, we were saying if the absolute value of the terms, if that series ended up converging, then so does the original. So we assumed that the absolute value terms series, we assumed that that converged, and that led us all the way down here to the sum of an converging. And that proves the theorem.